Braams werd geboren in 1833 in een arm gezin in Hamburg. Vader Braams was contrabassist en herkende al vroeg het muzikale talent van zijn zoon. Toen hij 10 was, speelde Braams voor het eerst in het openbaar als pianist, met groot succes. Daarnaast moest hij echter zijn ouders steunen in armoede en als 13-jarige speelde Braams piano in de kroegen van de haven van Hamburg. Het schijnt dat de jonge Braams een dichtbundel op zijn lessenaar had staan en gedichten las terwijl hij speelde, om te ontsnappen aan het tumult van de dronken zeelieden. Het Nederlands Philharmonisch Orkest speelt deze week onder leiding van Jacob Kreutzberg het vioolconcert van Johannes Braams met als solist Arabella Steinbacher.
Concerto of Brahms was considered to be very, very difficult for the violinists at the time. I mean, it is still one of the hardest concertos in the repertoire today. And Brahms had to rely on advice of his good friend Joseph Joachim, who premiered this concerto, to rework the passages to make them, you know, more playable. At the time when this music was premiered, it was considered that there were only two great concertos in the violin repertoire. That was the Beethoven and the Mendelssohn. And it did not help Brahms with this concerto that a famous conductor by the name Hans von Bülow made a remark comparing this concerto to another violin concerto by a composer, Max Bruch. And he said that Max Bruch wrote a concerto for violin, whereas Brahms wrote a concerto against the violin. Well, he simply meant that it is so difficult to play, that it is not natural for the instrument. This concerto was a very, very long piece, and it takes quite a lot of stamina and endurance from a performer.
German, so I think I should play Brahms anyway. No, but that's not the reason. I mean, of course, it's really beautiful music. It has so much passion. It has so much warmth, but also the, you know, German very serious way of, you know, very heavy too. But same time very, very warm and heartful inside. So it's a very, yeah, it's a big contrast in a way. Well, I think generally what is, especially for a romantic work like this, very important is to put all your emotion into it, and it gives so much back to you, so it's such an inspiration just to play this concerto, and then it wakes something up in you and yourself, and that you give also into the music again. I mean, for me at the moment also very moving, because I played it a lot with my father, and he just died last month, and so that and with all the sadness you also, of course it's hard, but music helps a lot, especially if you can play a repertoire like this, you can just give in everything, and that, yeah, it helps, and I'm happy that I'm able to play it here now in the beautiful Concertgebouw, and so looking forward to that.
The central movement of this concerto is of course the beautiful adagio, the slow movement, with its gorgeous, gorgeous long oboe solo. A kind of unprecedented introduction in its scope, in its length, to a relatively short movement. And it was another famous violinist, Pablo de Sarasate, who was asked if he was planning to learn and perform the violin concerto by Brahms, and he said, well, I agree that there is some very, very nice music in this concerto, but do you really think that I'm going to stand there with my violin down for the longest time and listen to the only really beautiful melody being played by somebody else?
Van die inleiding van het langzame deel is dat het een eindeloze melodie gaat. Er zit niet echt een begin en een eind aan. Het gaat maar door. Het vloeit. Het moet echt stromen. En na dat imposante eerste deel is dat iets wat van een heerlijke, zaligmakende rustgevendheid is. Ik denk omdat een hobo als geen ander instrument, blaasinstrument, het vermogen heeft om te ontroeren door zijn eenvoud. Het is ook heel vaak zo in films, als er iets ernstig misgaat, dan hoor je in de muziek hoor je heel vaak een hobo.
This particular concerto was composed or started to be composed in a very serious way. In the south of Austria, on so-called Lake Wörth. It is in that region that Brahms was known to make a remark. He said, here the melodies are in such abundance, there are so many of them, that you have to be careful not to step on them. I think that gives already an idea of where this comes from. It is pastoral, it is music about nature, there is no question about it.
Wij wensen u een mooi concert met Arabella Steinbacher, het Nederlands Philharmonisch Orkest en Jacob Kreutzberg.